Hello and welcome to the first Luminos Lab tutorial. And in this first tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a very simple representation of a helix. Depending on how complex your helix should be, you can either go for a very simple version, as it would be found, for example, in proteins or like a alpha helix, or you can make it a bit more complex and go for something like a DNA representation. Those short tutorials are all done in Adobe Illustrator. I might do some for other programs as well, but I'm not sure yet. However, I have to mention that all the techniques that I'm showing you today and in any further tutorials that are done in Illustrator can easily be reproduced in any other vector program of your choice. So let's say if you're used to working in CorelDRAW or in Inkscape, for example, you can easily incorporate those techniques into your workflow over there. So this is not an issue. Okay, so let's start right away. I'm going to start with just opening a new blank page, and I'm going to show the grid. This is something that I would highly recommend doing because it makes organizing your things way easier, as you will see in a second. I'm going to zoom in a bit, and the tool that we are going to use to create our helix is a pen tool. After you selected the pen tool, select one point where you would like to start and just click. And now it's important to know, do not release the mouse yet, but just rather drag it up or down or in any direction. What you see is that there are some handles that appear, and here it is very important to align the handles in a very vertical position, so exactly in a vertical position. And this could be achieved by simultaneously clicking the Shift key. Another thing that you need to remember is the height of your handles in this case. And this is where the grid plays a very important role because it's very easy to align it to the grid. I'm going to use a height of 4 squares. After you chosen the correct height, you can release the mouse and you see that this point over there is fixed. The next point that we create is shifted to the right side. So I'm going to move 2 squares to the right and 1 square up, for example. This is also something that can be varied and modified depending on what your helix should look like. Then I'm going to just reproduce the same thing again, clicking, dragging, adjusting the height, using the Shift key to align everything nicely, and just release the key again. And believe it or not, that was basically the hardest thing or the most complicated thing in that tutorial. Since we finished our first path, we are going to switch the tools and we are going to the selection tool. So now you see we created actually the first part of our helix. From now on, we are just going to use that element to create everything else. First, we would like to duplicate that version. You can do that by just going to edit, copy and paste, or just using the shortcuts basically. I'm going to use the shortcuts because it's way faster. And there is just one thing that is also very important here now, and that's the alignment of those two elements, of the old element and the new element that we created. They should be exactly above each other. If you're working in Illustrator, you might already know that Illustrator has the function to have those kind of magnetic helping lines or whatever you would like to call them. So the alignment is very easy to do. After those two things are aligned, we would like to connect the edges with each other. And this can be easily achieved. I'm just going to move that a bit down. That can be easily achieved by using the direct selection tool and just select those two points over there by just highlight or selecting it them like this. Then you can join those two points. That can be done by using the menu, going to Object, Path and Join. Or you can again use the shortcut. That's something I'm going to do quickly for the second point. Now you see already one part of the helix is done basically. And in order for you to see it a bit better, I'm going to fill the object with a color. Now what we would like to do is just copy and pasting the object that we created before. since it's a bit disturbing now, I'm going to hide the grid because we don't need it anymore. And I'm also going to give the second object a darker color. This object is going to be transformed. You can do that by just right-clicking on the object, going to transform and selecting reflect. And now you see if you reflect it in a vertical manner, the object is just flipping over. And basically this is the first part of the helix. I'm going to zoom out a bit and move that up. And by just copy and pasting this element a couple of times, we already get something that looks a bit like a helix. However, it's orientated in the wrong way. You see, it looks more like a ribbon and less like a helix. But that can be changed easily if we just bring some of the objects to the front and some of them to the back. In this case, I'm just going to highlight the light blue ones, right click again, arrange, bring to front. And now you see suddenly we have a helix. And this is basically the whole thing that you would need to do. You can modify the helix to your liking. You can give it, for example, let's say a bit of a shading. So for example, if we go for a light blue here and a bit of the darker blue here, and do the same for the part that is basically in the background. So you see now it gets some kind of a bit 3D looking version, and you can basically change all the things you would like on that helix. As I said before, you can also modify the single elements later on. That means I'm going to remove that as well. If you would like to have it a bit flatter, you can just modify the element by squeezing it, or you can even modify the single points over there. So for example, by just grabbing those, you can make it a bit larger or a bit smaller, or by just grabbing those two points, you can shift them up or down, but keeping the curve intact. So let's see what happens if I modify the helix like this. Just give it a simple shading again. Reflect it again, move it up a bit. Now you see that the gaps between the single elements are not that that large anymore. And like this, for example. If I switch back to the image that I showed you before, you see that that is basically the helix that we've done now. So a very simple representation. So if we have a closer look to the helix now, you might already see that it's basically just the same steps that we did before, and just having the single elements looking a bit different to create the larger gaps. So you see that in this case, if I just highlight the red elements of the helix and just highlight the blue elements of the helix again, you can just move them apart. So it's basically just one helix and another helix. And if you combine those two things, you get a double helix. If you want to, you can also incorporate like simplified versions of the base pairs over there, or you can make them even a bit more detailed if you need to. Good, this is basically it. I hope that the tutorial was helpful for you and that you might want to incorporate those things into your next scientific poster probably, or into your next presentation that you would like to give. If you have any suggestions on further topics that I should do a short tutorial on, you can always drop me a message in the comment section, or you can contact me via my webpage. You can go to www.luminous-lab.com and let me know if there is anything you would like to learn in such a tutorial. Good, have fun with designing your next scientific work, and see you in the next tutorial. Bye.